Hard one is right. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. It's 8 o'clock there in our nation's capital, Washington, D.C. That is the District of Christ, no longer the District of Columbia. We changed that name several years ago because the District of Columbia was named after a false god, Columbia. As members of the gospel, we said, no way. Let's see who we got here. Good afternoon and welcome to the Wiley Drake Show.
Yeah, hi, Wiley. Hey. I'm calling in. How are you?
I'm doing just fine, and I was shifting the microphone. Tell us your name again, please.
My first name is Janice. Last name is Hollis, Bishop Hollis.
Janice, how are you?
I'm marvelous, and how are you?
Well, I'm doing very good here in Southern California, where it's hot as a pistol, but other than that, we're doing all right. Out here in the beautiful Southern California area, suffering for Jesus, but somebody has to do it.
I understand.
Well, Janice, where are you calling us from?
Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. As a matter of fact, I would prefer to call you. I sent over my CV because we're supposed to talk about a project that I'm working on.
All right. Well, let me just tell you, Janice, I am the chairman of the Congressional Prayer Conference of Washington, D.C.'s television and radio network. And every day at 12 noon, we do a live show, and every night at 8 o'clock, we do a live show. I do shows from Philadelphia. I've done several shows from your Independence Hall. And the reason for that is we have a replica of your Independence Hall here in our little town called Buena Park. And it's an exact replica, but we're not calling to talk about that today. Janice, you're from the Philly area. I would assume my scheduler talked to you, Bob Bosworth. Is that right?
Jim Lindsay.
Oh, okay. All right. Hang on just one second. Hang on, let me see who this is on the line with us. Hello, God bless you. Welcome to the Wiley Drake Show. You're live on television. Are you there? I guess they didn't want to be on TV. Okay, Jim Lindsay suggested. Jim was just on with us. We did a live show not too many days ago here in California where we unveiled the Leadership Bible. Had a great time with it, presented the original copy of the unveiling to a young wounded warrior, female from Afghanistan. She was wounded in Afghanistan. She's doing very well now, but she is still a wounded warrior, and we gave her one of the leadership Bibles. And Janice, tell us about your project. What are you working on?
Churches and
Yes.
So,
well, Janice, we do quite a bit of work here in California as well as around the nation, not only with the kind of thing you're talking about, but with child abuse and children and so forth, and we certainly want to be of help with you. Did you put out a press release on this, by the way? Church Girl?
Church Girl. The Hustle Inside Religion. And the reason why it's raw is because the trafficking is with younger women, but it's also, and it's all based on true facts that came about with the book that's being released this month while through a publishing firm. And I'm fumbling here, and please forgive me, because it's unthinkable when we have older saints participating to hide what should be dealt with. It's heartbreaking. And when people read
it.
The book,
well, well, let me do this. Let's back up and sort of regroup here because I was not prepared for this, and I wish I could have been better prepared, and I will get better prepared. But the title of the book is called Church Girls, and who is it written by? Yeah. Well, Janice, what is your last name?
Hollis, H-O-L-L-I-S. It is available online. I don't know if I'm allowed to do this, so I'll wait for your direction.
Well, listen, let me tell you what we're about. Let me just tell you about our show. I am the chairman of the Congressional Prayer Conference of Washington, D.C., television and radio network. Now, I'm not saying that just to brag. I want you to know who we are and what we are. And one of the great things that the Lord has called us to do over the last 15 to 18 years is to take up causes. In fact, the matter is, when I began this, we began and are broadcasting to you right now on a radio station as well as television, but we're broadcasting on a radio station that's called Crusade Radio. And over the years, we've taken up many, many crusades. And most of the crusades that we take up are crusades to rebuild the family. And certainly what you're talking about is a tearing down of individuals and the family. And so the answer to your question is, we want to put the name of the book out. We want to work together with you. We want to help you in any way we can here on the Wiley Drake Show. So the title of the book is Church Girls. Ernestine Brown, and ladies and gentlemen, this lady's name is Janice Hollis, and Janice is bringing to us a crusade for the Wiley Drake Show, a crusade for Crusade Radio, as well as the Congressional Prayer Conference of Washington, D.C. We believe, Janice, that prayer is the answer. Whatever the crusade is, prayer is the answer. On the other hand, we believe in putting feet to your prayers. We believe in helping people that are praying and working on these crusades. So, with that in mind, let us help you any way that we can. And now I would like to give the microphone back to you and let you tell our listening audience, if they are concerned, as I am, and I know most of my audience are, if they are concerned as you are, how do they get in touch with you? Where do they get the book? And what can they do in addition to praying for you? What else can we do?
I am
Oh, my goodness. Well, let me know. I'm sorry? I didn't hear what you said. Go ahead.
Okay, very short. The woman sat before me, the attorney sat before me, and she says, I want to be very clear about my story. I'm not claiming to be a victim. I just want to use my story to help other people have the strength to do what I did. And she talked about her process of fasting and praying and asking God to take him out of her spirit. And she said she realized it was the initiation of her husband asking her for divorce after he was in a bad situation, being in other relationships, that she thought she was in a safe place going to church because she was so damaged. And she said, I realized I walked out of one frying pan into a bigger frying pan, and that lasted for years. She says, no matter how much I try to break it off. But it speaks volumes to those of us who sit in leadership and we see this, but yet we continue to give a pass. Now, I'm an African-American bishop. I have a problem with my culture when we continue to say, oh, we will just pray for Reverend, we'll pray for the bishop, when in actuality there's an affliction, there's a sickness, and we know it's sin, but there's also something that needs to be addressed internally. Because so many are abusers, so many come from abusive situations. And God wants to heal, but he can't heal what we will not give to him. In addition, in the Latino community, we see even equally as much abuse going on, but yet the culture is the same. It's almost as if it's taboo to talk about what's not pretty, but yet we have leaders bleeding over bad people. The conversation has to happen, and I would just like your audience to connect with us to be a part of that dialogue. I really would like to take this from Pennsylvania to another state, just to engage, get it going, because someone has to discern this, because it's not pretty.
Well, you're absolutely right, and quite often, as we have heard in the past from other situations with the Roman Catholic Church and the pedophiliacs and so forth, they have a tendency, unfortunately, when I say they, the churches, whatever denomination they are, to say, we don't want to admit we've got a problem, let's hide it, let's move it, and so forth. Now, let me say to you, if you have any person that has a story or a case they would like to bring, you know, what we deal with all the time is children that are being trafficked primarily, but we're willing to work with anyone. And what we do is when they cannot get help at the church, when they cannot get help at the courthouse, we take it to the court of public opinion. Now, we will let anyone come on this show so long. Now, you have to understand, my background is I was a private investigator for many years in the state of Texas, and so we do not take a case lightly. We do investigate, and so we do that now. But once we investigate the case and find out that it is indeed a verifiable case, then we will take it to the airways. I do two live television and radio simulcast programs every day, Monday through Friday. One at 12 noon, Philadelphia time, and one at 8 p.m. Philadelphia time, Monday through Friday. Now, we do not have a travel budget. We do not have a production budget for doing things extraordinary. However, we do have an excellent studio here.